Alright, hi guys. So today we'll be doing the same thing that we did for the past few days. I'll be going through two different other counters today. The first one will be Kalni Tyres, like I said yesterday, and the next one will be Ceylon Grain Elevators. So it's been one of the most requested counters, so that is why I'm going to do that today. So before I get started, I just wanted to tell you guys something. So far we have been getting a lot of engagement, a lot of views, and a lot of good comments on the two videos that I've done so far. So because of that, I have decided to make it into a video series where I'll be calling it 140 days of stock analysis. And what we'll be doing is that we'll be analyzing two stocks per day for 140 days, where we'll cover up the entire CSE market, so pretty much all the counters that is listed in CSE and actively trading, we'll be looking into them. So that was the announcement, and also I have a few other things that I want to do that I have in mind, which I will tell you guys probably during the new year or probably by the end of this month. So yeah, that's what I wanted to mention today. So yeah, let's get started. So what we have here on the chart is the chart for Kalni Tyres. So just like how we usually start any analysis, we just zoom out of the chart to see the overall price action. So far you can see that we had a good uptrend from over here, from roughly around the mid of 2020, which is the COVID-19 bottom, and all the way till January of 2021. So we had a strong uptrend, and since then we had a bit of a correction, a steep correction, but still looking at the overall price action, that was more of a correction than a bear market pretty much. So just a correction of an overall uptrend, and since then prices have pretty much gone sideways. So you can see this sort of rectangle here, which is what we call a base, and prices have been constantly trading between this 79 to 97 range. So as of now, the price action is consolidating. We have an uptrend, but for now the short term and the medium term direction is mostly in a consolidation phase. So now that we have that aside, we roughly go through the moving averages. So what we have here is a 20, 50 and 200 day moving average. So looking at this overall moving averages, you can see that they're not really signaling anything. The reason why it's all clustered around and it's literally on the same place, all the moving averages are pretty much on the same place, and that is a signal that prices are consolidating and there's no proper trend. So whenever you see moving averages like this clustering with each other without any sense, without any proper direction, that usually signals that the prices are in a consolidation phase. So in that case, as of now, the moving averages aren't going to help us, because one thing we know that it's consolidating. So moving averages by definition are trend indicators. So if there's no trend, they are not going to be of any help to us. Now, one of the key moving averages is a 200-day moving average. Now, as of now, you can clearly see that prices are hovering around the 200-day moving average. So we are not in a bear market, nor are we in a bull market. We are currently consolidating to find a proper trend. So as of now, the trend is mostly neutral. We do not have a bear trend or a bullish trend. We just have a neutral trend because prices are consolidating. So now that we have set aside the moving averages, we know that our direction is neutral and we do not have a proper uptrend nor a downtrend. Prices are consolidating. We have put that aside now, and we're just going to look at a few chart patterns. So looking at this chart over here, you can see that there is this trend line over here that is of some importance. So you can see a more of a parallel channel over here, right around over here. So what you call this is more of a channel than a rectangle. So because it's mostly sloping downwards, so you call it a channel. So prices are currently trading within this channel. Now, as of today, for some reason, investing.com does not have today's data for some reason. So I looked at the closing prices of Kalani tires for today, and it was up 10% from yesterday's closing. So today's close was, from what I know, was 100 rupees. So we have a breakout on Kalani tires. So now we know for a fact that this consolidation phase is over, because we clearly have a breakout and a close above this key resistance levels around this 96 area. So we have a channel breakout, and we also have a breakout above this rectangle face as well. So since price is closed above both those resistance level and near 100, and I believe that there was heavy volume traded today, so we have volume confirmation and price confirmation to confirm the breakout. So now what we have seen is two patterns. One is the channel, which is sloping downwards, and then we see a rectangle face as well, which both of them are consolidation faces. So looking at the moving averages, we told that since prices don't show any proper direction, the moving averages aren't really showing any sort of trending, isn't trending. So whenever now, since prices closed above 100, what usually you would see is that these moving averages will start to align with each other. So when we say aligning in a bull market, we need to see the 20 moving average above the 50 moving average, and the 50 moving average above the 200 day moving average. So that is how we define an uptrend through moving averages. The shorter moving averages should be above the next prior higher average below it. So if you're using the 20 and the 50 and the 200, the 20 should be above the 50, the 50 should be above the 200. So since this is the simple day moving average, it is less sensitive to data, so it will take a few more days for the moving average to align, unlike if you use exponential moving averages. So as of now, we have several things that we need to keep in mind. One is that prices have broken out above the consolidation phase, so we are most likely to start trending now, and also the moving averages are most likely to align. And looking at the volume pattern, it is also favoring the buyers. So a lot of good signals in terms of the chart on Kalani tires, which are favoring the buyers. So now that we have put all those aside, we need to figure out a price target. Now, a price target can be multiple things. We will use the primary pattern here, which is a rectangle face over here. And we can measure price target taking the lowest point and the highest point, and we find the difference and we add it to the breakout point. Same thing as we did for flags, symmetrical triangles, and all of them. So assuming that the almost around this high, let's take it as 96 rupees. So the highest point on this rectangle is 96, and the lowest point we can take it as around 80. So that gives us a height of 16 rupees. So now what we do is we add that 16 rupees into the breakout level. So our assumed breakout level is roughly around 96 rupees. So 96 added to 16 rupees gives us a price target of 112. Now, surprisingly, that 112 is exactly the high of January. So I usually like it when price targets correspond to like strong resistance levels. Usually most of the time they do work out, and most of the time they go to the price target. So now we have a proper price target. We know our price target is 112, and most importantly, we know that 112 is also a key resistance level, which was the prior January highs. So now we have set aside a lot of things. We know that we have a confirmed breakout. We know that the volume is favoring the buyers. We are yet to see moving averages align, which is something that's important. So since the moving averages aren't aligned, we might see a bit of a consolidation phase, not guaranteeing that we will. We might not. We have set aside a price target of 112, which is taken from the height of the rectangle. And so now that we have set aside all of those, we need to look at a stop level. Now, usually a stop level is whenever there's a breakout. So now we assume that our breakout was above around this 96 level. So now, since we had a breakout and there was a confirmed breakout, usually prices should not close below that breakout level. So if we are to give a bit more room to this, we'll put it as 95. We'll assume that our breakout is at 95. So if price is close below 95, that is a signal that most likely it was more of a fake out than an actual breakout. So a fake out, if you guys don't know what a fake out is when prices break out and quickly reverse back inside the pattern. So that just when you say fake out, that just means that it faked out the buyers into thinking that it was an actual breakout when it wasn't. So if that happens, that usually is a time to stop yourself out. So in terms of that, if you're assuming that a breakout was at 95, if prices close below 95 on the daily chart, that is a time to sell your stock and just stay on the sidelines until we get further confirmation. So as of now, we have a confirmed breakout and your stock as of now will go on a close below 95 rupees on the daily chart. Remember, it should be a close. If there's an intraday penetration below the 95 level, that does not warrant a fake out or a break below support. Prices need to close below support to say that actually the support level did not hold. So that's why I said that we need to have a close below our 95 level to warrant a fake out. So that being said, as of now, we have looked at almost all the things that we need to look at. We have identified the chart pattern. We know our price target is 112. We know that our stop level is going to be if prices close below 95 rupees on the daily chart. We know that the volume is favoring the buyers. However, the only possible negative factor is that the moving averages are yet to align. So remember that moving averages are lagging indicators. So because of that, more often than not, they will usually take time to align, but prices can move higher as well. So that being said, not exactly something that you need to be too worried about. So since that we have a breakout, most likely we might see a continuation in prices on Calendly Tires. So I guess that's about it on Calendly Tires. So we have looked at all the key things that we need to look at. So if you guys have any questions on this stock, you can obviously comment on the comment section and I will be happy to answer your questions. So that is done. Next we look at our final stock, which is Ceylon Grain Elevators. So we are going to do the same thing quickly like we did before. So what we see here is a clear uptrend, and then you see the COVID the January drop that we had, which was more of a correction of an overall uptrend. And since then, again, just like Calendly Tires, we have seen a bit of a consolidation phase within this range. So now that we know that the direction is neither bullish nor bearish, but it's more of an uncertain area where we are yet to see proper direction, we know that we need to wait for a breakout to get into this stock. So now that we have the direction aside, let's quickly look into the moving averages. So again, the same thing, 20, 50, 200. Again, you can see that prices are, the moving averages are clearly clustering around a very similar range. So that signals that the prices are not trending and it's in a consolidation phase. So now that we know that it is in a consolidation phase, one thing that we know is that we need to wait for a breakout, just like we saw in Calendly Tires. Until that, we keep this on our watch list and we look into other stocks that are most likely going to break out or have broken out. So now we know that there is this consolidation phase over here, and we have two separate patterns that we are going to look at. So the first pattern is obviously this rectangle phase right here. So we have the lowest point is roughly around 104 rupees, and then the highest point is around 147 rupees. So just to mark that area over here, so that gives us a range of around 43 rupees. So we know that how we measure a target is by finding the difference between the highest and the lowest point, and we add it into our breakout level, which is at 147. So assuming that that is a breakout level, we add 43 points into this and we get a price target of around 190. So that is the price target from the rectangle pattern. So we have another pattern here, which probably some of you might have recognized. which is an ascending triangle. Now, I know that a lot of you would have heard on YouTube videos and most other people say that if prices break below a bullish pattern like this, that's usually a bearish sign. Now, it is a signal that prices are most likely to trend lower before it starts moving higher. Usually, I have backtested this method that I'm going to talk about now, and it has worked really well in terms of entry points. Usually, prices do test this pattern low. So when you say pattern low, that is the starting point of the pattern. So you can see that clearly prices tested this pattern low and then started moving higher. So usually whenever you see a pattern like a symmetrical triangle or even an ascending triangle like this, if prices break below this upward sloping trend line, it's not a bearish sign, but it's a sign that you need to stay out of the stock, and most likely that your entry would be near the pattern low where you get a much better entry. So now that we know exactly what our patterns are, we have one, which is the rectangle, and two, we have the ascending triangle. So where is it going to be that we are going to get the signal that there's going to be confirmed breakout? So the confirmed breakout, like I said, is going to be the same thing as a rectangle. So it's going to be this line, which is at 147. That remains the key level for Ceylon grain to break in order to see an uptrend. So as of now, unless you got in at these lows around this 105 level, I wouldn't really advise trying to buy in at this level, because you're more likely speculating than actually knowing where the exact trend is. So like Kalani Tyres, where we saw a proper breakout above its rectangle resistance line, what I would advise is for you to obviously wait for confirmation before getting in. So once we have a confirmed breakout above 147, most likely we might see this stock extend towards our price target of 190 rupees. So so just to look at another key resistance level, which is obviously just like Kalani Tyres, the January highs is going to be the key resistance level to break. So that is roughly around this 167 ish area. So above that, we are likely to extend towards around this 190-200 target. So so we have looked at we know that the direction again is neutral. We do not have proper direction, we do not have a confirmed breakout yet. We know that there are two patterns which are most likely signaling a more bullish scenario than a bearish scenario. We can see that volume is coming in and the buying pressure is a lot higher than selling. We know that the moving averages are yet to align, so that is also something that needs to be kept in mind. We know that we have a price target of 190 rupees. And now finally, to sum things up, we need to figure out a stop level. So usually if you're already in the stock, your obvious stop level is going to be below 105 rupees. So if price is close below 105, that is a signal that you need to stop yourself out. That is if you have already got into the stock. If you haven't got in, then the best thing to do is obviously wait for confirmation until prices break 147. I know that you're paying a premium price if you're going to wait for confirmation, but in technical analysis, that's what we do. We wait for confirmation because we would rather wait for confirmation and get in on a good portion of the move than get in early and be wrong. So speculating on a breakout is a bit of a very risky thing to do. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So if you want to be a bit more conservative, if you want to be on the safe side, best thing to do is wait for confirmation. So like I said on all the other videos, just because we have a breakout does not mean that it's confirmed. There are times when it fails. So the best thing to do is obviously to wait for a confirmation. So now that I believe that we have covered pretty much all the points that we need to look at. So just to summarize everything up on this stock, we know that there are two patterns, which is the rectangle and the ascending triangle. We know our price target is 190. We know that we have a stop level for traders who have already gotten into the stock at 105 rupees. If you're gonna get in on the breakout, then your stop is obviously going to be on a close below 147 rupees. So those are the two stop levels. And then we know that still the trend is neutral. We do not have a proper direction. The moving averages aren't aligned yet. So again, it signals that prices are in a consolidation phase. Volume wise, the volume is favoring the buyers than the sellers. There is a good amount of buying going on in the stock, which is a good sign, which most likely signals that the stock is under accumulation. And yeah, I believe that's about it on the two counters. So if there's any, or again, if there's any questions that you guys want to ask, you can obviously comment in the comment section and I'll be happy to answer your questions. So yeah, that's about it for the video. If you like the video, make sure to subscribe, like and share the video, and most importantly, let me know if there's anything else that I need to add into my videos and to help improve my overall presentation. So yeah, that's about it. Have a good day, and hope to make another video soon. Thank you guys, thank you for listening.